I don't like to complain, but...
Well, my sources tell me that Mansoor and his Maximum Male Models crew have been rubbing people the wrong way backstage, and the Lock cast had enough of it.
You mean he goes for the cover?
No, kick out!
Too early in the match to end it.
Nice takedown. Legs are locked, and now the leg placed in a dangerous position. I think he's got it locked.
Needs to get out of the ankle lock and does so.
Running Hurricane Rana.
Beautiful.
It takes a certain level of athleticism to pull that off.
Ow. Foot meet back.
Oh, that's got to sting your back.
Oh, got the knees up. Could be a big turnaround here.
Oh.
Absorbed some damage already.
He had to be prepared to take some damage tonight.
Back around into a neck breaker.
Yeah. Oh, man. Figure four position, very creative.
God, that hurts.
Trouble there. Look out.
Slingshot right across the back of the neck.
Ouch.
Showing off the quickness. That'll turn things.
He can pin his opponent right here.
Oh, he kicked out.
The end was in sight.
Oh.
Nice side headlock applied.
Oh,
and a right hand for good measure.
Gonna take this match as long and as far as he needs to.
A rope step!
Just exhibiting their fearlessness.
Exhibiting guts and accuracy as well.
He's back into the ring.
Electricity of this moment is coursing through his veins. As Swan trying to get fired up.
A rope step!
To the outside, tope con hilo. That's finding any which way to topple the competition.
Hurling your own body like that is insane.
He gets back into the ring.
Oh my gosh!
Vicious right forearm.
Right here!
I think so!
He kicks out with force.
time to make his move.
Time to roll. Cover takes him down.
We got him covered. Shoulders down.
Oh, my God.
What just?
I can't. Irving Green, Saxton. Looks like there's no limit to how much damage this superstar can absorb.
That was planned out.
He may get the three count right here.
This is it. Kicks out before one.
Right now, I just don't know what it's going to take. Running Hometown Run.
Oh, Swanton.
Cover.
Two count.
And Taylor waiting for the lock.
Here is your winner, the Super Athlete, Vincent the Viking, the Voice.
I'm trying a new podcast segment called...
Superstar who's a lock to be on top of WWE for... Let's hope that Lock and Madcap Moss aren't claustrophobic, because they're about to face off in the tightest of quarters in a match where neither are allowed to leave the ring.
You say tight quarters, I say fight quarters, Michael.
And I say come up with better material quarters,
Saxton. Standing shooting star press, incredible. Quick reflexes, so important in a match like this. And that was taking the attack to the competition with that one.
Great presence of mind by Moss.
And they just busted out an impactful maneuver. And that was an efficient form of offense with that move. He's looking a little off balance. Boom, what impact. And Locke is really putting the pressure on.
Yeah, Locke is proving hard to keep up with.
Oh, you can tell he's feeling it now. This fight is pumping him up.
He's doing a whole lot of gesturing, and it could cost him. Sure, he's pumping himself up, but he's also giving his opponent a chance to recover. And a well-executed move we just saw there.
Ridiculous standing shooting star. Oh, not everyone can do that.
Locke might be looking to flop.
From the heavens.
From the top. This is just an overwhelming amount of offense on him.
Yeah, he has to devise some kind of new
strategy here.
He just won't give up.
That's gotta be it. He breaks the ref's count after one.
I don't know what more this superstar could do to put him away.
Springboard moonsault!
Wow! He may be in a bad way here.
This is where endurance becomes so important in the late stages of the match. This is downright savage club right there.
Lock saw it coming.
Oh, look at this.
Is it enough, guys? Is it enough to get back in this match?
Wow. So far, so good. Treating the torso to yet another attack.
He's looking poised to finish Madcap off.
Listen, I'm not gonna lie to you. We're a 3-hour show, and sometimes you just need to book a match. And it's already been a long day. So in that spirit, would you be a team player and step in?
The Intercontinental Champion has his hands full tonight against three of WWE's finest. One of my favorite matches, Fatal 4-Way.
I would love to get inside Adam Pearce's head on this one. Why these four superstars? Doesn't it seem a bit random?
Some mysteries are best left unsolved, Saxton.
Oh, the lock manages the counter. All right, Hurricanrana. And Dominic's resolve might be wavering here.
Dominic needs to reassert himself back in this match.
Ridiculous standing shooting star.
Sometimes you just gotta show off and show up.
Champa sitting back, studying his opponent. Waiting.
Great agility.
Comes back into the ring.
Shot after shot, then slam his face down.
And that was an effective attack, guys. He's lost some of his win now.
Yeah, he's taking some hits, but in a Fatal 4-Way, you expect to get a little roughed up.
Spinebuster!
With a sit-out. Nasty.
Oh, costly error there. Able to reverse that one.
moves like that, we kick the tempo up a notch.
The measure of Oz. Byron, come on, get with it.
Big boy.
Looking to hurt him. Oh, what a shoulder breaker.
Pendulum back.
Here's the cover. Kick out before the one count.
These men knew this match was going to be hard fought.
Side headlock applied. Good
measure.
Drop kick. Drop kick. Look at this. Boom. Nice. Referee breaks the count. Looks like a rope break. Ooh. Climbs back inside.
Definitely struggling to keep him down at this point.
Oh, God.
Alexander firing up, trying to get something kinetic going.
He's returning fire. Oh, look at the knees.
One after the other.
This match grinded him down a little.
You've got some guts showing up here.
Not really. See, Evolution and the Hurt Business don't have an issue. Until now. What it comes down to is you chose the wrong company in more ways than one. And now that decision is going to cost you your Intercontinental Championship.
And how is that going to happen?
One word. Omos. You don't stand a chance against him.
I'm not scared of Omos. Name the time and place, and I'll be there.
Hold up. There's no need to rush things. Let's get to know each other a little better. Do our due diligence. What I'm thinking is, first you have a non-title match against Carmelo Hayes. Sound good?
Sure. Doesn't matter to me, because it's all going to end the same. Me walking away, Intercontinental Champion.
Okay, Locke. We'll see.
Okay, Gabe, you know the deal. I want you out there for this match to make sure the Hurt Business doesn't get involved.
Got it.
Wait, do you really think that's necessary? I can handle myself fine. And what's the worst that can happen anyway? A DQ and I get some shots in on MVP and Omos?
Or they get some shots in on you and weaken you before your title match against Omos. Come on, use your head. Gabe, you're going out there with him for that match. I don't want to hear another word.
Come on, let's go.
Transform WWE forever. The Lock and Carmelo Hayes are squaring off tonight in a highly anticipated non-title match between two superstars destined for greatness.
The Lock has more than just his IC title with him tonight, as Gabriel Slade will be joining him at ringside.
Is Randy Orton losing trust in Locke's ability to get it done all by himself? Or maybe he sent Gabe out to keep an eye on MVP? It's hard to get inside the mind of the Viper. Drop kick to the side of the skull.
Oh, Swanton. Oh, on a running senton. Flip. Lock watching attacks left and right.
A killer instinct from the Lock is shining through.
Springboard. Ooh. His shoulders are down.
No, a kick out. It'll take more than that to hold him down.
which we are seeing on display here.
From the middle rope. Oh, my God. He returns to the ring.
let's get this out of the way. I know you didn't want Gabe out there for your last match, but this is too big to risk anything. So I'm going to be in your corner to make sure you hold on to your title.
I appreciate the support, but I'm confident I can win this on my own. Besides, you said I was the next version of you. Let me live up to that for once.
Our goal in Evolution is to hold championships, and we do that by any means necessary. So I'm not saying you need me to win, but I'm going to be out there to make sure it happens. You know Hurt Business will be doing the same thing. We'd be stupid not to.
Look, I realize they have numbers just like us, but I know I can handle myself. So I'm asking both of you to just stay in the back.
No one's going to think any less of you if you have someone in your corner.
Gabe's right. This isn't the time to prove a point. So why are we even having this conversation?
Gabe would say whatever you wanted him to, but I'm not like that. Yes, we're part of a team, but I'm a future world champion. The Phenom, right? So I need to prove to you and myself that I can do this. That Evolution isn't some kind of crutch propping me up. You said I could trust you when I joined Evolution, and now you need to trust me on this.
Message received. You clearly know what's best for you. Good luck.
Champion capitalize on this opening.
MVP making
his presence known.
Well, it looks like the Hurt Business are the ones who are going to capitalize.
Chokeslam down to the mat.
Omos with a pin attempt.
The referee's coming too.
One, two, three.
He did it.
We have a new giant intercontinental champion.
Ultimately, the combined effort of the Hurt Business is too much for the Lock to handle, which makes you wonder, where was Evolution?
And now MVP and the Hurt Business are taking it to the former champion.
Again, where is Randy Orton? Where is Gabriel Slade? Their teammate just got beat down.
Let's not lose sight of the fact that we have a new Intercontinental Champion in Omos. But I agree, there's definitely something off with Evolution.
Where's Orton and Slade?
They were just heading back towards your locker room.
Hey, what the hell was that all about? Where were you?
You told us to stay in the back. Remember?
Yeah, I said stay in the back for the match. But then, in case you missed it, the Hurt Business attacked me. I could have used some backup there.
Can we get some privacy?
No, I want everyone to see this. What's your deal? Were you trying to send me some kind of message?
Actually, we were on our way out to help you, but I got overruled.
By who?
Me.
What?
I've heard people say I'm a follower, that I lack killer instinct, that it's held me back my entire WWE career. Well, I'm done with all that. I made the call to stay in the back.
I trusted you. We were teammates even before all this Evolution stuff.
Teammates? You've never cared about me or anyone else. Every decision you've made has been to benefit you and your career only. Getting me involved in that stupidity with the New Day was a wake-up call. And then your stubbornness against the Hurt Business only cemented who you are. It cost you your title. But that hurts all of us. So explain why we should go out of our way to help you.
This is ridiculous. Just like always, you're just saying all this because you know it's what Randy wants to hear.
No, I'm saying it because it's the truth.
I tried to let you do things on your own, and you failed. Repeatedly. What's next? You're gonna bring down our whole group with you? So maybe I was wrong from the start. Maybe Gabe is the future world champion in Evolution.
Let's face it. You're not the Lock. You're the weak link.
I don't need you or Evolution. I never did. I'm better off on my own. I quit.
Good.
Clear your stuff out. I don't want to see you again.
So, since we last caught up, you got into a fight with New Day over a video game cover, lost your Intercontinental Championship, and then quit Evolution. String of bad luck, or all part of the plan?
All part of the plan. You might be hearing Orton and Gabriel's spin about how I was the weak link, but really, they were the dead weight, which is why I got rid of them. I realized I didn't need to be a part of some retread faction to get ahead. I'm bigger than that. I can win the WWE Championship on my own, and that's what I plan on doing.
Well, I certainly believe in you, but what's next?
I know I'll become WWE Champion, but something has been off since I debuted. And it's been holding me back way more than Evolution ever did. So what's next? I'm going to confront this issue head on, in front of the entire WWE universe.
Former Intercontinental Champion, The Lock, has requested this time to address the WWE Universe.
He certainly has a lot to address.
Let's be real. I haven't had the best run lately. Most notably, I lost a couple things. My Intercontinental Championship, and then my faction. But this wasn't how things were supposed to go, right? You all heard and saw the endless hype. I was brought in to WWE as the next big thing, a future world champion. And of course, The Lock. It worked for a while. But let's be honest, it felt forced from day one. I never was truly comfortable with what I was asked to do. And when it comes down to it, these recent setbacks were just a result of those early decisions that were out of my hands and way above my pay grade. What I'm saying is, I was set up to fail by WWE management, and especially VP of Talent Development, Shawn Michaels. Let me shoot with you. Shawn was behind all of this from the start, forcing one bad decision after another. So, HBK, I want you to come out here right now so we can talk man to man, face to face.
Strong words from The Lock.
Yeah, you better be careful here.
And Shawn Michaels apparently has chosen to come out and respond to these claims.
This is a situation that might be better handled off camera, behind closed doors, not in front of the entire WWE Universe.
He doesn't look too happy to be put on the spot like this.
I heard everything you said, and I'm willing to talk. But you know, this isn't the time or the place.
This is exactly the time and place. I want everyone to hear how you've mishandled my career since the day I got here.
Stop. Now.
No. I've played by your rules, but I'm not going to trust the process any longer. From now on, I do what I want to do. That's what got me here in the first place. My voice, my instinct, my talent. You and your corporate yes men have tried to stifle that every chance you got.
Okay. You really want to do this? We've heard your side of things. Here's mine, AKA the truth. All you've done is complain since day one, thinking you know everything. Like when you chose to drop your special lock entrance after one match, and then you dropped your custom attire right afterwards. You know how much time and money was invested in all of that, and you never gave any of it a fair shot. But there's no change in your mind because you're too stubborn to listen to people who actually know the ins and the outs of this business. The same people tried to set you up for success, who wanted nothing but the best for you.
Hold on. The best for me? Give me one example of something you did to help me. Come on, name one thing.
Okay, let's get it all out there. When things weren't going as expected, I went to Randy Orton and MVP and convinced them to start factions to try to get you back on track. That's how much we believed in you, that we were willing to stick our necks out for you. But I guess that's all stifling and setting you up for failure, right?
You said they wanted me.
Yeah, because I knew feeding your ego would be the only way to get you to agree to do it. But even that didn't work, because you couldn't learn to cooperate and quit, throwing away an opportunity that everyone in the back would kill for. So I have one final thing to say to you. Don't you ever confuse potential with success. Because you might have all the potential in the world, but it doesn't mean anything if you can't get out of your own way. Stop complaining and blaming everyone else and do something for once.
You want me to do something? Is that what you want?
Words being exchanged here.
I'm talking to you. Show me some respect.
Shawn just took a very awkward fall there and hit the steel steps hard on his way down.
I don't think that was intended, but things just took a very bad and unexpected turn.
I think he was just trying to get Shawn's attention, and it backfired.
Officials, including Michael's good friend Triple H, have arrived to check on Shawn.
Probably best for him to just leave and let things cool down.
You're fired!
Did Shawn Michaels just say he's fired?
I think I heard that too.
Wow, I can't believe that just happened.
This has gotten way out of hand. We just hope Shawn's okay.
We've got a ton of moves to capture before our special guest arrives, so let's get through this as quickly as possible. footage of a top rope move. Come on, let's see what you got. What time does the MyRise crew get here? They're such an asshole to deal with. Oh, did I say that out loud? My bad. Friendly reminder to all talent and crew, please only use 3 squares of toilet paper. We have sensitive plumbing here. Now taunt the imaginary crowd. Whip in any direction. I don't care. Combo. see why WWE fired you. You can't take a simple direction. Okay, might as well get some more combo footage. Give me a light one. NBA. Dribble with your left hand, dribble with your right hand. Now shoot. So much easier than this. Hit a signature move while you're at it.
Is that my old buddy, The Lock, doing mocap for WWE 2K? It wasn't that long ago when you thought you should be on the cover of the game, and now you're here pretending to be a WWE superstar? Talk about a fall from grace. This is amazing.
What the hell are you doing here?
Maybe you can't afford to watch premium live events anymore? But I just won this Money in the Bank briefcase. So I requested that my briefcase motions be captured accurately by me and not left to the interpretation of uncoordinated losers like yourself.
The same uncoordinated loser who beat you repeatedly?
Funny. Oh, and look, I even have WWE here to document the whole thing. Remember when you used to have a camera following you around? The irony is off the charts.
Hey, hope you're doing okay. I always believed in you.
That's enough. You're here to film me, not speak to the extras. Okay, you can leave now. I need to shoot my part so I can fly to the next show. You know, the life of a busy, successful WWE superstar.
All non-essential talent, please clear the ring. Thank you. All right, let's settle into a T-pose. Mocap ready, position. Action on your briefcase victory scene. Great, excellent. Now up to the corner, please.
You think you're better than me? Huh? Answer me!
Cut! Cut! That's enough! Where's security?
Come on! Let's do this! Let's go!
I should have sued you before, but now I am definitely going to.
Let me go!
This was assault, and it's all on camera!
Get off of me! You haven't seen the last of me!
Actually, I think we have. You're fired. Again. Bye!
Sorry, Sammy. Let's take a break, and we'll continue when you're ready.
No, no break. Let's just do this. Make sure you cut all that out, okay?
Should we wake him up?
Yeah, I think he's got enough beauty rest.
Oh, what the...
Morning, sunshine!
What's going on here?
Since you never returned any of my messages or calls, I had to come see you in person.
You flew all the way over from the UK?
I couldn't just sit back and watch you throw your life away. And since you're impossible to reach, I got in touch with this lovely lady. Am I allowed to say that?
I'll allow it.
Anyway, she's been following you around for the past 6 months and knew what was really going on with you more than anyone. We agreed you weren't in a good place and needed help.
This really isn't necessary. I'm fine. Seriously. I've just hit a bit of a rough patch. That's all.
A rough patch is when you lose your keys, causing you to miss a blind date, and your cat gets sick. Of course, you find out the reason your cat's sick is because they swallowed your keys, but that's a personal experience, so we're getting off track. Point is, you've thrown away everything you worked so hard for.
And then yesterday, you got fired from the mocap gig.
Yeah, and I had my flight booked way before that. You've been a mess for a while.
I didn't throw everything away. It was complicated. But if it gets you two to stop, I'll admit, I've had better days.
More like better months.
So you got knocked down a peg of five. All that matters now is how you respond. And when you're done feeling sorry for yourself, there's a whole world of wrestling out there for you to build yourself back up, be everything I know you can be, and show WWE what they're missing.
You're right. I've let things spiral out of control. I'm ready to get back on track.
Great. And I'll be right there with you. Every step of the way.
Really?
Got nothing better to do.
Okay. I'm confused, though. Why are you here, Kat?
I told you, I believed in you. And besides, I can't just start a project and leave it half finished. Especially when it's going to have an awesome comeback story. And hey, even if you crash and burn, that'll be great too. For me and the doc, not necessarily for you.
All right. We're at an airport. Where to first?
The loo. This coffee ran straight through me. On my flight over here, I was thinking about how we met.
You couldn't stand me. Said I should quit wrestling and go back to where I came from.
Well, that wasn't very helpful, was it? I was actually thinking of what happened after that. You wrestled on some shows I was promoting, and you were impressive as hell. However, there was one thing you always churned down.
The bartender at the pub? You were constantly trying to set me up with her, but she was like 75.
No, not that. I mean, I always refused to do a British Rules match. And by the way, Amelia passed away last year. God rest her soul.
Those matches are super restrictive. Way too many rules for my style. I like to do my own thing.
Now, is that working out for you? As a lesson to be learnt from working within a structure.
Okay, Shawn Michaels. Look, I see what you're getting at. But I don't think you can relate to what happened to me in WWE.
Really? When I was in WCW, they asked me to wear a stupid robe and wig and be the stereotypical blue-blood British guy, and I refused. You know who they asked next? Triple H. He turned out okay, didn't he? Sometimes you have to learn how to play within the system.
And trust the process, right?
Not what I was going to say, but sure. What I learned is you can wear the wig for a bit and then you can always take it off. At least, it gave it a fair shot. So what you say, we head over to the UK and you finally compete in a British Rules match. Prove to me you're ready to wear the wig.
Okay, fine, I'll give it a shot. At least I won't have to deal with any more awkward situations.
Great. And by the way, Amelia's younger sister's the bartender now. I think you'd love her.
Let's go get our flights before you...
How you feeling? Did you knock off that pesky jet lag?
Yeah, and I know British Rules matches can be grueling, but I'm ready to give one a shot.
I hope you're ready to give more than one shot.
What do you mean?
This is actually a British Rules tournament, as in, you'll be competing in multiple British Rules matches.
I agreed to do one, not an entire tournament.
I know you wouldn't have come over here if you found out you had to do more than one, but here's the thing. If you don't get your act together, you'll lose in the first round, and you won't have to worry about any subsequent matches, will you?
I'm already regretting this.
Oi, suck it up! You're gonna be fine. And besides, the crowd is already here, so there's no backing out now.
Okay, Tavish isn't around. What'd you think of what he did to get you over here?
Not surprised at all. Tavish means well, but he'll lie his butt off if he thinks a situation calls for it.
Does the fact that this is a tournament change your approach?
Now that I'm here, I'm not going to take the easy way out. If I have to compete in three of these British Rules matches to win the tournament, then that's what I'm going to do. It could really help kickstart my comeback.
This is awkward, but I wanted to seem cool. I honestly have no idea what a British Rules style match is.
It's been around forever here in the UK. The matches are 2 out of 3 falls, and there's no leaving the ring or top rope moves allowed. Got all that?
Yeah, definitely.
Bottom line, it's going to be very tough to win this tournament.
especially since it's all taking place in one night. Nonetheless, I'm just happy to be out of the WWE bubble, and no matter how it goes, I look forward to getting out there and being myself.
Look who wore a wig. And you're gonna get to wear it some more.
It wasn't bad, I guess. Actually, kind of fun.
Well, your next opponent is gonna be tougher. But the important part is that you're learning to get outside your comfort zone. And if you manage to win the match, even better.
You have any kind of scouting report on this next guy?
Oh, no, I didn't catch his last match. Some fans bought me a pipe. Nice blokes.
So how did you know he's tougher then?
Made it up. Seemed like a coach thing to say. Anyway, I'm headed back for another free round. Good luck. Another win! Way to go!
Thanks, but why are you wearing your old wrestling attire? Let me guess. The fans at the bar wanted pictures with you in it.
No, but it's not a bad idea. Could make some extra bread. Anyway, it turns out the bloke you were supposed to face got hurt in his last match and can't compete in the finals. So, yours truly volunteered to fill in.
Seriously?
Well, we couldn't send the fans home without a tournament winner now, could we? Besides, some of them are my mates now. Jimmy's getting married next month, and he asked me to perform the ceremony.
Congrats.
So what do you say? You versus me, British rules, may the best fully rested, slightly buzzed man win.
All right. Let's do this.
Hey, I'm actually happy to run into you. WWE's having me cut together a greatest WWE Rise and Falls video package featuring you, which I kind of feel bad about. I've got all your footage from your so-called fall, but if you get Kat to get some shots of you dominating your next match, I can try and make it into a Rise and Fall and Rise package.
Thank you.
WCW, and welcome to what's sure to be a night that will definitely never be lost to history. It's Tavish, one of WCW's brightest and most interpersonally off-putting stars, takes on the brand-new blue-blooded bruiser, Jean-Paul Levesque.
Short work of things here.
Oh, God. Brutal chop block. Oh, Swanton. Right hook.
Oh, look at this. Oh, man. Inside out.
Oh, kick right to the back.
Oh, man. He is fired up now.
This isn't the smartest thing to do, antagonizing your opponent instead of attacking him.
Oh, the arm's trapped.
Oh, a slam. Cover here. An easy kick out there.
He's really trying to rush this match.
Oh, what a right hook. He got whipped into that corner.
What a counter.
The count.
And Tavish setting up.
Retaliation from John Paul. Each competitor showing it in their own way. Caught him right in the jaw.
What a shot.
Start counting, Saxton.
One, two.
And that was a precisely measured attack.
Going up top.
He's heading back to the ring. Ooh, that hurt right in the kidney.
Golly.
Hooked up. Shin, and he goes for the pin. No, he kick out.
A lot of energy left in that kick out. This matchup isn't anywhere near over.
Oh, walloped by a huge club. Big forearm. He reverses it. Took it off the knee.
The sound of this crowd is deafening, and he's asked.
Not allowing that to go on any longer. He catches Levesque with a big counter.
Time.
catches Levesque with a big count.
Catching Levesque off guard.
He thinks he has it. Cover. He kicked out at two.
Wait, are we sure that was not a three count?
You can't count that high, Saxton, but that was one of the closest near falls you'll ever see. And the heaviest hitter in the arsenal was not enough.
Taking a moment to let the crowd know how much he appreciates them.
Saving us from having to sit through that. Flapjack.
Gosh, landing face first.
Oh, a little chop block. Oh, a swanton. Oh, what a flip.
Nice body control.
Oh, what a knee.
Of a match, right?
It took you having the performance.
Damn right.
I can certainly.
Here comes trouble. Welcome back to WCW, everyone, for what can only be described as a dream match between the unlikeliest of tag team mega talents.
On one side of the action, we've got John Paul Levesque and the British Bulldog representing the Union Jack. Facing off against the always outspoken Tavish and his mystery partner, who I can't seem to place. Also, why are we calling it a WCW match? What's happening?
Don't overthink it, Saxton. Embrace the chaos. Running Hurricane Rana! Fantastic. You've solidified your name as a top athlete when you're able to pull off that move. Hey! Showing a lot of fury with these attacks.
He's mixing precision and physicality with his attacks here.
A rope step! Beautiful, all the way down to the outside. That is reckless abandon being shown.
And paying off as well.
Gets him with the counter.
Bulldog might be able to start mounting something here.
Davey Boy could be turning his fortunes around.
And that was a well-executed attack.
Boom!
No, oh, gosh.
Simply refusing to stay down.
And Tagiri finds its mark. And an impressive amount of offense against him here.
He can't just think of running this out. He has to get on offense.
Look at this. Boom. Nice. Retaliation.
this point. You don't even stay down long enough for one count is beyond comprehension.
This match's brutality starting to show on him.
Yeah, they stuck it out for this match, but it wouldn't hurt to go for the tag soon here.
Ooh. He saw it coming.
Into the floor.
Oh, the arm's trapped.
Oh, the slam. Tag.
The British Bulldog playing up for the crowd right now.
A running Hong Kong.
Beautiful.
Shot, they're slamming their face down.
Oh!
so is punished. The core of the entire anatomy can dramatically slow your movement down.
Snap power slam for the win.
He kicks out in two.
I am in shock. What's it going to take to keep this guy down?
Tight,
and that one misses the mark.
Look at this, going counter.